You mentioned The Chosen earlier, and we talk about folks who are in your church that work in media and Hollywood and stuff like that. They've been under fire recently for the flying an LG flag, which once the details kind of came out, it was an independent contractor on his own personal equipment, always has his own flag on it. What do you make of all that?
Well, I actually just released the whole thing on it on YouTube and Rumble, on my Rumble and YouTube page, and talked about this in length. But the short version is, I mean, if I can just speak freely,
of course.
I mean, obviously, that's what we've been doing. Yeah. I appreciate Dallas and Jenkins and The Chosen. I mean, I can't find anything where, doctrinally, because they have artistic liberty. Like when I preach, I mean, Jonah could have looked like this, and the whale could have looked like this, or the big fish, and he could have been thrown. You know, you paint your own, even the best Bible teachers on the planet paint their own version of what's going on in their mind. The woman at the well, 4 foot high, 6 feet in a diameter in the butt. You know, and so that's all they're doing. So I personally don't have anything
with the creative
the creative license it. But my thought is, you're making a movie about Jesus, and hey, if you're that's your life, so that's fine. But to bring the flag, it's kind of like in your face, bombastic, arrogant, boom, pride on the set of a Christian movie about Jesus. I that's what I disagree with. I would have told the guy, we love your work. Hey, you're welcome here as an independent contractor, but that really sends the wrong message to have that flag on this set. And so, I mean, but what do you,
I think what you're saying is very reasonable.
Yeah.
I think Dallas's response is also very reasonable.
Yeah, it was. You know? It was a good response.
Like, we're not going to police everybody. Yeah. We're not going to tell people what they can and can't do, especially it is different when it's an employer-employee relationship versus it's an independent contractor. I also could see like the flip side of that is just that can get really weird really fast.
Well, but we hire independent contractors a lot, and we say, hey man, you can't be drinking here on the job site. Also, you know, not going to be playing AC/DC Metallica, just with the kids. And so I think because you're hiring them and you can set the standard on which the environment, especially a movie about the life of Jesus. So again, I appreciate Dallas's words. I see where he's coming from. That would be a hard. That'd be a hard one to navigate, and he did well.
Yeah.
But I would have handled this a year ago and said, hold on a minute, that's kind of brazen.
Yes.
Like you can, we're still hiring you, even though we know about your lifestyle because we love you, we appreciate you, but you're not going to take that a step further and put this sign of perversion on the set of The Chosen.
Yeah,
that's what I would do.
Do you think that the crux, like if we have to get down and pinpoint and get clarity on what the issue is The Chosen closer to a church and a ministry, or is The Chosen closer to a media company, for-profit business that's ran by a Christian? Would we say that's kind of where the crux of the issue is?
Well, I say because of the message.
The content. You kind of categorize it more as a ministry and as a church.
The testimonies, have been huge. It's about the life of Christ as close as possible.
Yes.
The actors, the design, the following the Gospels to a T, and it's the Gospels being lived out on film. So to me, it just doesn't even make sense. So I think he got away with it so long, didn't want to address it. You know, I've been there. Hey, I don't want to address this. And now that it came out, he's been here a while. We kind of let him do his thing. And I'm not going to forget Dallas and how people are saying some mean things. Like, he handled it like a business owner should handle it. But to me, more than a for-profit company, it is an incredible ministry with incredible testimonies and incredible outreach that is really bringing the life of the Word of God to life. And that really just sends the wrong message.
Yeah, I think that's fair. And I think if Dallas was, and I feel like he said something to the extent of like, if he could have, they would have caught it in the edit.
In the edit.
Yeah.
Well, but that tells me, I would have caught it before it even started a year ago. I guess that's my point. Now that I wish we would have caught it in the edit. Well, that tells me it's still okay to be on the set. My whole point is I wouldn't even have it on the set.
Yeah. Hey, you want to see something kind of crazy? Over 75% of the people that watch this channel are not subscribed. Please consider subscribing and turning your bell notification on so that you don't miss anything we have going here.
It's like because you're making this beautiful movie of Jesus dying on the cross for the sin of the world, and now that's a sign of perversion, deviance, pride in God's face on my camera. Every single filming. Now maybe I'm too, I'm black and white, that's how I would address it.
I understand where you're coming from. I think that the tricky part becomes now.
What do you do
with this all or nothing thinking? The Chosen is I mean, literally getting categorized with Target and Bud Light.
Yeah, no, that's not good. No.
Right?
Yeah.
And we would go, okay, we could disagree on if a flag should have been on the set, right?
And I even said that. I go, I wouldn't. I'm still going to have my kids watch it. I went through it. This is what I went through it. I remember the first episode, I had a piece of big, you know, those notebook papers and a pencil. I'm like, all right, I'm just going to do a podcast and critique this thing.
Yeah. Not a whole lot to critique.
I'm like, through three episodes, I'm like, man, this is incredible.
Yeah.
I'm being touched. Tears are, and then of course you get the negative Nellies and, oh, you're, you know, this and that, and, you know, because we're supporting it.
Sure.
But no, I wouldn't let that stop me from, I think supporting. It was an honest mistake.
Yeah.
And maybe from his vantage point, you know, he would have did the same thing, but I don't think that's enough to, because all of us have cracks in the armor.
Sure.
You know, come follow me around for a month.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, where are you going to, you know, throw the baby out the bathwater?
I guess I see it more from the perspective of a creative, that when I'm making music, for example, I'm trying to make the very best product possible as efficiently as possible. So the gentleman that mixes my music is a non-Christian, smoking Palestinian, who has serious issues with Israel.
Right.
And I just went to Israel in October and we had some tense conversations, you know?
Yeah.
And so I'm like, I was all over Palestine.
It's a good ministry opportunity for you too.
Right. Right. But my thing would be if I tag him in something on Instagram, people can easily go and look up his gram and he's smoking.
Yeah.
If he has a Palestinian flag on there, right? All these different things are very close parallel, but me tagging him in something and saying, I got the best engineer in San Diego possible because I want to make the best product possible unto the glory of God, I think people can take it and conflate it in the same way.
True.
So, Ruslan, what are you saying? You're endorsing the cannabis industry now?
Yeah, yeah.
No. Are you endorsing Palestine? No.
No, not at all. Yeah, because they did the homework to follow up.
Right.
So, to me, the chosen would be like that man sitting on your set smoking the skunk.
Yeah, well, longer. I mean, I've been in the studio with him and you know, stuff like that, but I probably wouldn't post something like that. But if he were to post something mixing
that's
my music,
yeah.
you know, and there's a Palestinian flag and a lot of weed smoke,
yeah.
you know, I may even reshare it, you know? I may even reshare it on my story, and I would hope that people would understand the nuance in that resharing it, which, to your point, probably not the wisest thing to do, is probably, I would hope people would see that resharing it is not the same as endorsing it.
Exactly. That's what I think with Dallas, not the wisest thing to do.
Yes.
I agree, but not to where, Target, same as Target. No, it's just, okay, well, or maybe I told somebody this the other day, I wasn't in his position. Mm-hmm. Did he have to hire, this is the only guy available, the best work possible?
Yeah.
And then the flag came up and he didn't know what, like, we just got to offer some amount of grace, too.
Yes. Because to be fair, I have no idea what it's like to run an operation
that big,
or to build media that big.
No.
Because it's totally different than what we do here. There's no one on these cameras right now. I'm controlling everything from a stream deck.
True, true.
When you're talking about hundreds of people, extras, sets, all that stuff, I don't even, that's just so above my pay grade. I have no idea.
And we've had a call, you know, I won't go into a lot of detail, but we've had to call an emergency sound guy in. I know he's not a Christian.
Mm-hmm. Hey, this weekend we have a super special Father's Day sale, 25% off the entire shop. And as always, free shipping on orders over $85. I'm super excited because we just got this brand new oversized French Terry hoodie. If you've ever gotten any of our premium hoodies, you know that not only will they last you a lifetime, but they just feel amazing. This is by far my favorite hoodie. I'm 5'10.5", gotta give me the half, and I'm 175 pounds. I'm wearing a size medium, so these do run oversized. We also got brand new oversized royal blue shirts and this super dope tan sand color. So you could check those out as well as the entire shop, the everything, okay? And again, if you know me, you know I always tell you, buy it nice or buy it twice. We don't do the fast fashion stuff that's gonna fall apart and the cheap stuff. We really try to go above and beyond to give you guys the best quality merch, and we want to give back to our Father. So check out the sale, blessgod.shop right now. Use the code Father's Day at checkout, and you could stack it with that free shipping over orders $85. All right, I'll see you over there. Peace.
And he's doing our soundboard for a Wednesday night service.
Yep.
I mean, I'd rather err on the side of we have sound and we have media than, oh, this guy's not a Christian.
Yeah. So if he would have showed up with the LGBTQ flag on his hat, or there was a small patch on his jacket, what would you have? 3-inch patch on his jacket. He comes in with one of those bomber jackets. There's a LGBTQ flag. You guys needed somebody to go in there. How do you tell him to take the jacket
off? I'd
probably
pull him off his side and say, hey, man, I don't know if that sends the right message. We're glad we hired you and stuff, but we got to be sensitive to, you know, where we're at. We're here in church.
Yep.
And
What if he goes, sorry, man, like, this is my identity. I'm here to serve you guys. And what do you do? Do you send him home?
Well, fortunately, it hasn't happened.
Okay, I'm playing hypotheticals here.
Well, if he started to get an attitude and prideful, then yeah. You know, that would be
another. If he showed his pride.
Yeah, showed his pride. Showed his pride. I don't know. I'd have to cross that bridge when I get
hard.
To it. Yeah,
it's
that's
hard.
That's what I meant
it's
by
hard.
Dallas.
Yeah, and that's what I mean. Yeah. Like, I feel for Dallas because I don't know how I would approach that conversation.
Absolutely not, because people could pick apart. Yeah. Gosh, we've done things in the past where people
And is it legally, how does it work legally, right?
Like, well, you have to hire him. You can't discriminate because of sex. Preference and things like that. So he's absolutely can be a cameraman.
Yeah.
But then to take it and put his flag on it, that's where, you know, you kind of cross the line. Dallas might have in his policies and procedures, you know, our definition of marriage, and you're breaking policies and procedures by this flag.
Right. Yeah.
I don't think
he does have that in the procedures from the way he articulated, but it's tricky.
It's tricky. Yeah.
But I think Dallas would probably agree with me. I would have definitely not had that in the edit.
True.
And I think that just would have saved a bunch of hoopla.
Absolutely.
But I also know Dallas has always been very forthright. And guys, we don't hire just Christians. There's a lot of atheists. Yeah. There's a lot of LGBTQ people that work here. So, you know, I was talking to him about coming on and checking out the show. And so I think in that conversation, he was very transparent. And then like you can come, you can pull up and while we're filming and all that kind of stuff. But like, you're not going to be walking up on Jonathan getting an interview here. he's in his zone. People are working.
It's not much
know.
Different than we had our new roof done on the church. Mm-hmm. And you invite the people to church. You give them CDs. You give them the book. You minister to them while they're there.
Yep.
You know,
that's good.
Hey, this is a segment from our daily after party stream. Consider partnering with us online for as little as $5 a month to get access to these daily after party streams completely unedited. You'll also get access to our podcast as they are streamed live into the community before anyone else gets to see them, get to interact with our guests, get access to our private Discord server, and a discount code for our store for as little as $5 a month. Ultimately, that will help towards helping us continue contextualizing the gospel using media and podcast here on YouTube. All right, I'll see you over there. Peace.